Hello?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I do hear you. Go ahead. I hear you actually, but you did not hear me first time. Go ahead. You are a Muslim,
Oh
right?
yeah, I changed my.
You are a Muslim,
Yes,
correct? Okay, what do you like to say to us? Go ahead.
yes. I'm just watching your videos all this time, and all the time you're spreading lies about Islam. Lies.
Like what? A Gog and Magog?
Lies.
Is Gog and Magog a lie?
All the timeline. You know, Quran is most perfect book ever.
Okay, tell me about
You know, the
Gog.
Bible.
No problem. Tell me
The
about
Bible
Goga.
was written 300 years after Jesus, even when they said he died.
Okay.
What proof do you have? Where is the first Bible? Where is the second Bible? Where is the third Bible? Where's the fourth Bible? We don't even have a full copy before 400 or 500 years after Jesus died.
Well, let
So
us
how can you say
let
Quran
let
is not
Let
preserved?
us go with
Quran is
this.
not.
Okay, do you have a full copy of the whole Quran before the first four centuries? Do you have a full copy
But
dated?
we're not.
Do you have a full copy? You see, I'm going with you now. Do you have a full copy dated to before the fourth century?
It doesn't matter if we have
But you
full
just said
copy.
to
We
me,
never
but
needed
no,
to
no,
preserve
but
it.
no, you just said,
We
but you just said, but you just,
hold on.
you
We
just said,
never
hold
needed
on,
to
you
preserve
just
it
said, look
the
how
way
arrogant you
you
are.
needed to
Look
preserve
how
it.
arrogant you are. You just said to me, we don't have a full copy of the whole Bible before the fourth century. You said that, and but you are the one who believe that you have the same issue. If this is an issue for you, that's when you should not believe in Islam. Secondly, Muhammad, he came 600 years after Jesus, after the Bible is written. What is the proof of Muhammad that he knew what is in the Bible? If all the Bible is corrupt, the mic is yours.
But we never say the Bible is corrupt. We say you don't have the real Bible. So
So
the Bible could be somewhere. The Bible could be somewhere in the Middle East. You just haven't found it
it's
yet.
not corrupt. Okay, hold on, hold on.
You made up a different copy.
All right, hold
You
on.
made up a different copy and then spread it all around the
All
world
right.
to give to the Christian people.
All right.
The original copy could be there. Original copy could be even at the time of
Okay,
Muhammad, but you hid it from
the
everyone.
Bible,
You
the
rewrote
okay,
it.
so but you don't have the
I
copy.
mean,
No,
how
but
tell me
nobody,
one thing, how many
my
Christians,
friend,
how
my
many
friend, my friend, my
Christians
friend, my
have
friend.
read Bible
Let us
that
talk.
comes in Greek
Let us talk.
or
Let us
Aramaic?
let us talk. How many Muslims they speak Arabic?
It's 15%.
15%. That's mean there is what? 85% of Muslims are not Muslims no more?
Doesn't matter because
But
we listen to people who
a
speak
second
the
ago,
language.
but a second
But
ago you
we have.
said, a second ago you said, if we don't speak Aramaic, you said, how many people speak Aramaic? How many people speak Greek? How many speak Hebrew? And now you are saying doesn't matter. You see, I don't know. Are you a mature adult or you are a
Okay, okay,
kid?
okay. How
Now
many? How many? Okay,
let us be
1.6 billion
let
people.
us be logical.
15% is a lot.
Okay,
15% is how
okay,
many million?
okay. Let us
How
be.
many hundred million is
Doesn't matter.
15%?
And
How many
we
people
have
speak
millions of
Hebrew?
people who speak Greek. We have millions of people who speak Aramaic. We have millions of people who speak Hebrew. Same. We have
There you
so.
go. You go a few million,
Doesn't
maybe
doesn't
5
and
million,
doesn't
10
matter
million speak Greek.
as long people they speak. Now the question is, do you understand the Quran, which is written in Arabic? Do you understand it yourself?
I don't understand it myself, but I look at
So you
translations.
are proud about what? You are proud to be a Muslim about religion, and you said to me the Quran is perfect, but you cannot understand the Quran. How the Quran is perfect, yet you cannot understand it.
Because we can trust our scholars. You cannot trust your
Okay, as long you
scholars.
trust your
Look at
scholar,
what they are doing. Look at what they are doing. The church is
okay,
doing in every country, East and West.
as long you trust your scholars, is the ant a Muslim?
Of course, look, even the Quran tells you that only Allah can understand the true meaning of the Quran, but the very well-versed people, the knowledgeable people, they will understand as well parts of it.
That's a false
So that's
interpretation,
how the Quran works.
my friend.
We
You are ignorant.
only need to read.
You are ignorant, and the verse doesn't say that. Why you are lying? The verse says only Allah knows what the Quran mean, and the one who are in, have knowledge, they say we believe. They don't understand. The one who have knowledge is the
Of
one who
course,
say,
because we believed,
okay. So,
he shows us the way.
but you just lied, and you say that the scholars they knew. When the Quran says only Allah knows, and those who have knowledge, they say we believe. So, in order to have a knowledge in Islam, it's just you have to believe. What kind of religion this religion is? How you can be a scholar if just by saying I believe? How that make you a scholar? And what kind of book? Only Allah knows what it's mean. Don't you think this is
So
stupid?
what? Okay. Let's say Bible, obviously Bible is more clearly written because it's a newer creation. It's created for the masses. It's created to lie to the masses.
But
Obviously,
isn't
you're
it?
gonna put lots of
But
graphs
isn't
in
it?
it,
But isn't it the Quran? But
lots of
isn't?
nice things in it,
Oh, hold on,
nice
hold on.
story, make
Okay,
it for
hold
the
on, hold on. Ho
movies,
okay,
make
hold
it
on.
for the
Hold on, hold on, hold on.
Yeah?
You Muslim, you
Okay, I'm
say. You
holding.
Muslim, you say. And even Yasir Qadhi, he said that the earliest Bible is exist is goes back to the 60 years after Christ. The earliest Quran you Muslims have goes back to 400 years after Muhammad. The earliest recitation you have is coming from Hafs, and Hafs, according to Muslims, is a fraud. So where is your Quran? The Quran says, "Inna alayna jam'uhu wa Qur'anuhu." Allah, He says, "I am going to collect the Quran and I will recite the Quran." Did Allah collect the Quran?
Yes.
Where? Isn't it Uthman? He collected the Quran and he burned the other Quran.
It
So,
doesn't matter what man does to the Quran because
no,
Allah
it
is
doesn't
protecting
matter.
it all the
It
time.
doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Isn't it the Quran
It doesn't
says,
matter whether they
no.
burn it, whether they sink it in the Nile. It doesn't matter. It
Why?
doesn't
Why?
matter
Why?
what
But
the
why he
Egyptian
burned it?
government
I
does, what
thought you.
the Saudi government does, because
I thought you
at the end,
Muslims.
we will be
Listen.
left
Listen.
with the
Listen.
original Quran.
Listen, you don't have original Quran. You just say it doesn't matter, they burn it. So where is the original? If there was original, it's burned. And I'm asking you now, why he burn it? Why he burn it?
Okay,
Why he
maybe
burn
that's Allah's way of
why he burn it?
preserving it. I don't know. I don't know
You
how Allah thinks.
Allah why Uthman is a messenger of Allah?
Well, he doesn't need to be, but Allah can take control of anyone at any point. His
Okay.
power is endless.
But
If he wants to use one of the
the Quran, but
if he wants to use the people to fix the Quran for himself, he will.
my friend, the Quran says
If he wants,
Allah will
hold on,
call.
hold on. If
Listen, listen. Are you saying to
Allah
me,
decided to.
are you saying to me that Allah is Uthman? Because the Quran says Allah will collect the Quran, not Uthman.
Yes, but Allah can take control of any human being at any time. He can do everything with a human being.
Yeah, but Allah, He says, I will collect the book, not Uthman.
Yeah, but he doesn't say how. He doesn't say how. It's
He
still
say
Allah. Look,
still
if
is
he
no.
possesses
So
you.
Uthman is Allah. So me now, if I have my own Quran, then I am Allah too. It's Allah who made me do it. I mean, this is a joke. Where is Muhammad then? So what Muhammad doing? Where is the book of Muhammad?
Look, let me tell you one thing. If Allah decides to preserve the Quran, it doesn't matter how. This could be any method he can use. Even the Egyptian, when the Egyptian government was fixing the Quran, how do you know that's the Egyptian government? That's probably Allah using the people to pick the right recitation. So how much? 95% of the world use Hafs?
Okay, let me ask.
Yes. So that means
All
almost
right.
everyone apart from few
All right.
regions use Hafs. So that means Allah has managed to preserve the copy he wanted to preserve.
How he preserved? No, Hafs is not really the copy he preserved. This is the copy printed by the oil of Saudi Arabia. Before that, nobody used Hafs
Yes, but
recitation.
how do you know? How do you know
We
that's not
know
Allah's way of
because
preserving it?
before it was most popular, like Warsh, other reading of the Quran. It's not Hafs, but because this is what was more popular in Saudi Arabia, and the government of Saudi Arabia is the one who published this. It is published. Same time, let me ask you: do Allah allow people to write the books by their hands?
He can do everything he wants
No,
to
no,
do.
no. I'm asking you. Don't tell me. Stop saying to me he can do everything. And this is another question. Do Allah allow
Well,
you as a.
it is the question. It is
No,
the question
listen.
because
Li
you're saying
no,
there is something he cannot do
listen
or he
carefully.
cannot allow.
This is not the question I'm asking you. Are you allowed as a Muslim to write the book by your hand? The book of Allah.
Look, if I grab an empty mushaf and I start writing, Allah will correct my hand. So I cannot make mistake.
Really? Really? Are you sure?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay, well, I'm going now to play for you a video, and this video have recitation of the Quran, and you just said you don't know Arabic, so how you can correct it? How Allah can correct it? How Allah can correct you? You don't know even Arabic.
I don't need to know it. If Allah takes control of my hand when I'm writing, he will fix it, isn't it?
Okay,
It's as simple as that.
did Allah take control of Muhammad writing?
He took control of what he was saying, isn't it?
Okay, that's wonderful. So the one who took control of Muhammad of what he is saying is Allah. So when Muhammad he bowed down and he recited the satanic verses, was Allah in control or Shaitan?
No, but he fixed it. Allah was not in control of Muhammad all the time. Obviously, he only needed to take control when he was reciting verses.
Okay, so that's mean Allah and Muhammad, they are, sorry, Shaitan and Allah controlling Muhammad, and you agreed.
Yes, but
Okay.
look at the story. No,
Okay,
hold on, hold on. Let me finish this point. Let
let me
me. You
ask
started
you.
a very good point,
Okay,
brother.
let me ask
You
you.
started a very good point.
Hold
Hold
on.
on,
No,
hold
I want
on.
to finish this one. You just say the very important thing. That's why I want to. You will have time, don't worry. We are just having a nice conversation. Thank you for calling me, by the way. You are a nice guy. So listen. So as long as you agree that Muhammad is controlled by Allah and Shaitan, but Muhammad received his command from who? From Shaitan or from Allah?
Well, look, he received commands from both, yeah, but Allah being the more powerful, listen, Allah being more powerful, he fixed the rest, isn't it? Same as Jesus. When Jesus was tempted by the devil, God helped him resist that, isn't it? That's part of the, it's even in the Bible today.
No, that's not true. The devil, he could not, you see, when it says tempt, he tried, but he did not tempt him, he did not fail.
How
So
do you know he did not take control of Jesus? If you guys can correct the
You
Bible
can
later at any time, how do you
draw.
know?
Okay, don't play games now. You can correct. I can say the same to you. You can correct any time. And look at me. I have a hadith in front of me. It says, "You're a prophet." He said that Shaitan he command him to do good. What do you say about that? It's in front of you on the
Hold
screen.
on, let me go through that. There is none among you whom is not an attaché from. They said, Allah messenger with you too. Thereupon he said, yes, but Allah helps me against him, and so I am safe from his hands. He does not command me but for good.
What do you think? Shaitan, he command Muhammad good command. The devil.
Obviously Shaitan, he did not command him because Allah fixed it.
No,
I
no, no,
mean,
no, no, no.
if you read the
Stop
story,
saying,
Allah
my
fixed it,
friend.
didn't he?
What's your name? What's your name?
No.
What's your
If
name? What's your
the satanic verses were not
what's your
corrected,
name? What's your name?
if the I don't want to reveal my name, but
Say,
if the
give me.
satanic
Give
verses
me
were
a name.
not
Give me a name to call you by, whatever your name. Just give me a name. Give me a name.
call me anything you would like.
Muhammad.
I
Okay,
know you
Muhammad.
love
Okay.
to use
Okay, listen.
Abdul.
Look,
You
listen,
love to use
Muhammad.
Abdul
No,
all
I'm
the
not
time.
going to call you Abdul. You know, you look like you are more educated than normal Abdul. And now you you are very educated. I can't tell. My friend, you don't even know how to read. It says he command me but to do good. So not Allah fix it. Like the Shaitan is commanding him still. Muhammad describing the command of Shaitan as a good command. So why you are saying Allah he fix it? What's wrong with you? Don't you know how to read? Did Muhammad say what you are saying, or you are fabricating things? He said, so, but he does not command me, but for good. So Muhammad saying that Shaitan is a good person, and he obey his command, and his command is good. Muhammad here is admitting that Shaitan.
No. Look what it says. Look what it says. But he does not command me, but for good. So anything that's bad, he cannot command him because Allah helps him.
Okay,
But
hold
if
on,
it's
hold on. No,
anything good
hold on.
comes out of it,
Okay. But
if anything good comes out of it,
okay, so Shaitan
obviously,
he give only good command to Muhammad. Like what? Give me an example. How Shaitan he's how we
not
call
only, not only.
how we
I'm saying.
can hold on, how you call him devil, and yet he give good command. Explain to me. I want to learn from this about you, about Islam. Go ahead. He's the devil. The devil he do give good command since when?
Does he have to? Is there anywhere where it's specified that he does only bad things?
Yeah, well the shit
And you know,
well the
hold on. You
well
know, lots of good things can come from something bad, isn't it?
No, that's not true. Not according to Islam. Shaitan is Shaitan. Isn't it the Quran says the Shaitan he want to mislead you, the Shaitan he want to deceive you, the Shaitan he will take you to hell. So now suddenly the Shaitan he's a good guy? Or the
I'm not saying
Quran.
he's good, but look, he does not command me.
Yeah.
But for good. So anything good, he
Okay.
might be, Allah might allow it to go through the gaps. But if anything bad, Allah does not allow it.
Okay, that's wonderful.
I don't know
But
how
you
you're reading the verse.
agree that Shaitan he gave him satanic verses, and Muhammad, he recite them. So how Allah allow it to go through?
So that he can then show his power by abrogating them.
But how, you, that's if, mean, that's
if,
mean, okay,
if
guys.
Muhammad didn't know, my friend, if my friend, Muhammad hold, didn't know, hold on, and hold Allah on. Didn't interfere, he would never know he revealed them, but he knew he revealed them, and it got fixed, isn't it?
How
and it that's
fixed?
Showing
can
that
Allah can you tell me? Can you tell me the story how Allah fixed those verses? What happened? Muhammad don't know. Muhammad recited the verses. And then
yes, and then Gabriel came
okay.
and told him, "This
right.
is not from. This is not. It didn't come from me. So why are you reciting it?" So
that's
Muhammad
wonderful.
Didn't know.
That's wonderful. Hold on. Guys, listen carefully. Our friend here, he said that Muhammad recites Shaitan Quran from Shaitan. Muhammad did not notice that this is not from Allah. Then Jibreel later come to his house and he told him, "This is not from Allah." Do we agree about what we said? That's what you say?
Yes.
Okay.
This is not from Allah, yes.
But so how the Muslim they say nobody can make Quran like Allah? Here we go, Muhammad, he received Quran from Shaitan and he himself the prophet. Who can be better examine the Quran more than Muhammad himself? If I recite Quran now and you recite Quran and then Muhammad in front of us or we bring a sheikh, which one you choose? Muhammad, right? He's a prophet, correct? Which one will judge which one
yes.
is Quran? Okay. So Muhammad now here he failed. He received Quran from the devil. And yet he did not figure out that this is not from Allah. Even the verses saying bow down to the daughters of Allah. So how he did not notice why he was drunk?
But look, Muhammad was never a perfect person. He was not Jesus.
Friend,
Jesus
this is
was
not about,
perfect. Not even.
Okay, hold on, guys. Did
but
you,
Muhammad
did,
was,
did you just
Muhammad
say,
was a mortal man.
Did you just say that Jesus is perfect?
Of course, the Quran says he was the most righteous of all of them.
Okay, so
Muhammad was never
no, no, no,
the
no, no,
most
no. He, not righteous.
Righteous.
You said
all of
you
them.
Said you said perfect. Muhammad is not perfect. You said that Jesus is perfect.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay,
he
wonderful.
Was a man.
If there is any man is perfect.
No, of course no, and I'm not saying he was perfect.
You just
he doesn't
said that,
need to be perfect to do God's work.
But you just
was
said,
Moses
but,
perfect?
But you just
no.
But you just
was
said,
Abraham perfect?
But you just,
no.
But you just say that he is perfect. You everybody heard you. You said that.
Of course.
Okay.
Even Allah says he made Jesus.
Okay.
He was the most righteous of
so,
all of them. He was
so
the most
you,
perfect.
So
he
when
seen.
You say so when you say he is perfect, he is perfect. There's no so-so. Either perfect or not perfect. So Muhammad is not perfect. Jesus is perfect. Wonderful. Muhammad received satanic
yes.
verses. And that you are saying, because he is not perfect, he did not notice that he was praying to the daughters of the devil. And because he's not perfect, he bowed down to them. And because he's not perfect, he still went home and did not notice. And because he's not perfect, still he need the angel to come and tell him. And because he's not perfect, Allah, after that, he need to fix the Quran. Hold on. If we go now in the Quran to the chapter we are talking about, the chapter of satanic verses, chapter 22, you will see here it says that Allah is going to take off what Shaitan he threw. Do you agree with this? Allah will take
yes.
it off? Okay. How we knew that this verse itself is from Allah, not from Shaitan? If Shaitan was able to throw Quran already in Muhammad, and Muhammad did not notice. How we knew that this verse itself is not from Shaitan saying, don't worry, Muhammad, I will give you more. Don't worry about Shaitan giving you things. I am Allah, I will take it away. How we knew that this verse is not from Shaitan? Because already we agreed that Muhammad received from Shaitan, and he don't notice. So Shaitan, he can do it again, and again, and again, and again. If he was able to do
no,
it once.
No, but you're doing mental gymnastics at the moment because you're saying, oh, how do we know the whole Quran was not the devil's work? Well, it wasn't because we know this.
How?
And we know exactly where Shaitan involved because
where?
Allah wanted us to know
where. Where? What Shaitan?
And he fixed it.
What Shaitan? Okay, what Shaitan he want? Tell me what Shaitan he do? What Shaitan he do?
He tried to intervene. He managed to get a few words in, and then Gabriel came and fixed it.
No, no.
By
what,
Allah's
what,
will.
What was when Shaitan intervened with a human being in general? What he tried to do? Like, what he do? I mean, what he promised you? How he can tempt you? What he do?
Well, he always tries to take them off the righteous path.
Okay. Was Muhammad a righteous man?
He tries to be.
Okay, was Muhammad a righteous man when he went to his own son's wife and he flirted with her in her house when she is married?
Did he flirt though? Does anyone say he flirted with her, or does it say that she liked him, thus she wanted to marry him?
No, it says that he said to her, Subhanallah mu'allif al-qulub, praise be to Allah, the one who flipped my heart for you. And he said that loudly so she can hear it. Is that a good man? He go to the
All
house.
Alright, show me the hadith. Let's go. Let's show me the hadith. Let's read it carefully.
All right. Let us see. Let us find the reference. Give me a second. Here we go. This is chapter Al-Ahzab, verse number 37, and this is the official government website of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. All right, I put it for you on the screen. And then you will see that when he went to the to his son, he found Zainab standing, and she was wearing very sexy clothes. It says here, read carefully. You don't know Arabic, but I will give you the link. You can use Google Translation. It says here, or you can give it to any Muslim who speak Arabic. So he went to Zaid seeking him, and then he found Zainab standing, and she was white and big and beautiful, and she is from the most perfect women of Quraysh. So she's so beautiful, you know, okay? Fahawiha, so he fell in love with her. He fell in love with married women. And then he said, وقال, Subhanallah muqallibu al-qulub, fasami'at Zainab bit-tasbihah fadhakaratha li Zayd. So Zainab, she said what she heard what he said, and she told her husband. Fafatina Zayd, and then Zayd is oh, here we go. So now he knew that she's sleeping with him. So he went to Muhammad. He said, Ya Rasulullah, please let me divorce her. She is proud. She have a bad tongue. She hurt me with her tongue. And then Muhammad, look how hypocrite. A second ago, he was in the house of the man, flirting with the wife. And now he's saying to him, no, 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 keep your wife for you, man. Keep your wife for you. It's in front of you. And this is what? Read. This is your Islamic tafsir, Tafsir al-Qurtubi. And this is the official government website of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. I will post the link in the chat. You can click and you can use Google Translation to translate. What kind of a prophet he go and do such a thing? This is the man you trust him with the Quran. This is the man you trust him with the ethic. This is the one you trust whatever he says to you is from God. And he is the good guy. He's not perfect, no problem. But here we go. I mean, this is very bad. First of all, he adopted this son. Imagine he changed the adoption just because he want to have the girl. He changed the adoption. He adopted the man for years. And suddenly, just because he saw this woman, he want her. He canceled the adoption law. He forbid people from adopting. And he right away the man he noticed says here Fafatina Zayd. So Zayd he noticed what's happening. Obviously she's cheating with him. You see here the story doesn't say that they're sleeping together, but obviously they are working together in the same direction. And you are the one who just said to me, no, she like him and she wanna marry him. You said that. So she is not a good woman. A good woman who is married to a man and they are not even in seeking divorce. She want to marry other man, and he is his father. And then we find that Muhammad, he go to the house, flirting with the wife when the husband is away. Be honest with me. If your father come to your house, and he flirt with your wife, and he said to her, my heart to flip for you, what you will do with your father? Be honest.
Okay, first of all, he was an adopted son, so he's
doesn't
no
matter.
Father.
Even this is more ugly because you give the
second of all, you give, can we you not give agree?
A, you, when you adopt a son, and that's mean you give a word of honor. You just say that Muhammad have no honor. You just say that.
Okay.
Because if I
can
adopt,
can we not agree that God, if he wills, he can use horrible men with bad flaws to do his will.
So you are saying,
and he always has.
So you are saying,
and he always
Muhammad,
says, Moses was not perfect.
So you are saying, Muhammad
all of
is
the
a ba-
previous prophets were not perfect.
So you are saying to me, Muhammad was a bad man.
Well, he was the man for the job in the Middle East at that time. He was the
Okay.
man for the job, apparently,
Okay,
because
he is the
maybe he
man
had a
for the
strong enough
job.
will.
And
He
what is the okay,
he might have had
and
might
what
have had earthly
what is
needs.
the job? What is the job of Muhammad? Look what the interpretation is saying. And if the prophet, his eyes fall into a woman, her husband must divorce her so he can have her immediately.
Yeah. So why wouldn't God give a little bit of an incentive to his prophet so
Oh,
that
this
he
is
will get the job done?
oh, the incentive of the prophet is to give you women who they are married to other men just because you like them. This is incentive. This is bonus to Muhammad. I mean, what kind of logic this logic is? So if I go now to your house and I see your wife and I am a prophet, it's bonus for me. It's not your right to complain. This is not against Allah teaching. This is not against ethic. No, it's an incentive. Incentive to the prophet. Why the incentive?
Was it against Allah's teaching?
Huh? What?
Was it against Allah's teaching?
Don't you Muslim says the Quran says Allah, he said to you when you go to visit somebody, put your head down, don't let you look at the women. Don't you know this is against Allah teaching supposedly, yeah.
Yes, and then what did he say? That if any woman looks at him, he can marry her.
What woman
So
look at her?
obviously
He
he's
is the
lying.
one flirting with her. I mean, she's married. What's wrong with you? She is married. You go to the house of the man, you have no honor. You have no honor if you go to a house of somebody, and you, especially
Would
you.
I do it personally? I wouldn't do it personally. Would I
Why?
allow this to be done? Probably not.
Why you will
But
not
if he
do?
was the
Why
man
you
for
will
the
not
job,
do it? Hold
if he
on.
was the man for the job, if
Why?
he was strong,
Why you will
he
not
could
do it?
convey the message
No, no, no,
of
no.
to
Wait,
his
wait,
people at
wait,
that time.
wait, my friend. Why you will not do it? Are you saying you are better than Muhammad?
I'm not saying I'm better than Muhammad.
You.
All I'm saying is that I would not do some things that he would do. So simple as it is. We're all
Why?
different.
Why?
We're
No,
not.
no, no,
If I
no, no,
could
no,
be,
no, 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 no. You just said
if I could be same, I
I
could be
will
same
not
either
do
way.
it. Why?
We are not
Okay,
all the
but
same.
isn't it you Muslim? You follow the Sunnah as the Prophet he did. You follow his step in whatever he did. Here we go, Muhammad. You go to the house of people, flirt with the wife, so you can do it. This is Sunnah.
Well, I can't do it.
You can do it, right? So this is Islam.
Well, I can give a try, certainly, but I doubt God would now approve of me because I'm not doing his work, am I?
Why you are not approved? You just said we follow Muhammad's steps. He is the best man to follow.
Look, you have to understand that that time in the Middle East was a very violent and hard
My
time.
friend, what this have to do with
So
the
God needed a
what
very
this have to
strong
do what
prophet.
this have to do with violent now? The man, he is his son. They are not in war. He go to the house. The, okay. And what
All I'm
kind
saying is he wasn't
God
perfect
and
as a man.
what kind of God he
Had
says?
desires.
Okay, hold on. You see, you Muslims, you jump from a place to a place to a place, and it's endless. So you agree that Muhammad is a bad person. That's a wonderful news. I want to
I
ask
don't
you.
agree he's a bad person. I agree he has a humanly needs, and they might be different than your humanly
So if I
needs, but
so
he's got
now
his own
I
humanly
have a
needs.
human being needs. So if I see a woman, I rape her, I say I have a human needs, right? Is that okay, right?
Well, obviously not, because that's forbidden.
No, it's not forbidden. Where it says it's forbidden for Islam to rape? Show me the verse in the Quran.
Okay, hold on.
I will give you 10 years. Actually, I will show you where it says you can rape. I will give you 20 years, not only. You know, you can search Google from now until the coming century. I
No,
never.
there is a verse. I just
No,
forgot
there's.
which verse it is
No,
that
there.
showed
No,
which
no, no,
women are
no.
permitted.
No, 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 no. Take your
Which
time.
women are permitted to
No,
you?
no. I will wait for you. I will wait for you. Here we go. Search Google. I will give you 10,000 years. Show me the verse about rape. Go ahead. I want to learn from you. Google is very fast, my friend. Search. Verse about rape in the Quran.
All right, Quran 424.
4:24.
And also prohibited to you are all married women, except those your right hand possess. This is a decree of Allah upon you. And lawful to you are all others beyond these, provided that you seek them in marriage with gifts from your property. That's no rape.
This is the verse, actually.
How is that rape?
This is the verse. I have it on the screen ready for you to show you the rape, because it says forbidden for you married women, except. So you can rape women who they are married. Do you know how to read? It says, it says forbidden for you women already married, except, except who? Except married women. Who they are, your right hand possess.
Except those whom your right hand possess.
Exactly.
Okay. But how many women does your right hand possess? How many women does my hand possess? None.
In the time of Muhammad, he have hundreds. This is not the topic now. You see, are you a kid? Are you a man or adult or a kid? So when the Quran says you can rape those who their right hand possess, it's mean you can do it today. You have them or not, because now you are weak. You cannot go and conquer and rape women as before. But if you can, you will. So the Quran saying you can rape women who they are married. And you said to me, you will show me a verse against rape, when this is the same verse says you can rape them.
Well, look, because the Quran has built a better world, and that's Allah's plan for us.
This is better world?
We no longer possess any women.
How this is better world? No, you do. This is an order for you, but now you cannot do it because you are weak. If the Muslims are the most powerful country in the world, you will do it. Not long time ago.
If we're all the most powerful, there would be peace all around the world.
Exactly.
Because we would all follow this.
Exactly. Peace. Everybody will be killed. The women, they will be raped like ISIS, right? Peace. You know, by the way, I don't know. You speak about peace. You say, if we have a peace, isn't it the Quran forbid you from having peace?
Well, if the whole world is Muslim, obviously we will have peace.
So you will keep killing until nobody left, not a Muslim, and then you will have peace, correct?
Yeah, but why do we need to kill if we can just convince people? We can just convince people that this is the truth.
You just said if all the world become Muslim, then we need to not to kill, my friend. And nobody's convinced. People are loving Islam. And let me ask you. We just mentioned a second ago about Muhammad having sex and Muhammad going after women. Is that Muhammad or Allah making Muhammad having sex with women illegal way? Who is the one who made us do adultery? Is it Shaitan or Allah?
Why would we do adultery? He didn't sleep with them before he was married.
I'm asking you. No, hold on. No, he did. He did it with Mary the Copt. He did with Sophia. He did with Mary. I can count for you endless numbers. Now, I'm asking you.
Look, you can find many fake hadiths.
No, not fake hadiths.
We know about the hadiths that Christians produce and sleep
Abdul, Abdul, listen. If you want to talk to me, either you speak with your brain is open, or don't call me, because when you say fake hadith, you have to prove it. So are you challenging me now to show you a hadith which nobody can prove that it's fake? Is that a challenge? You cannot do that. I will show you from Al-Bukhari. We show you from Sahih Muslim. So stop playing this game. I'm asking you now a question. When a person do adultery, who is the one who make him do adultery, Allah or Shaitan?
Shaitan.
Thank you very much. Guys, did you hear him? Shaitan. The hadith says that Allah is the one who make you adultery, and you just admitted that Shaitan is Allah. Read for me, and this is a very sahih hadith. It says here, you read it, your English is better than mine. Go ahead.
Okay, put it on the screen. It's a little bit off screen, please.
It is in the screen.
All right, thank you very much.
Go read, I want to hear it. Hadith is like
verily, Allah has fixed the very portion of adultery which a man will indulge in and which he of necessity must commit. The adultery of the eye is the lustful look, and the adultery of the tongue is the licentious speech, the heart desires and yearns which the parts may or may not put into effect.
Okay, so what do you understand from that? I'm listening, go ahead.
That men need to feel the necessity to do bad things, but Allah has fixed it.
What fixed it? No, it says, you see, I don't know, like, are you playing dumb now? Are you playing like you don't know English no more? It says, verily, Allah has fixed the very portion of adultery. Who is the one who fixed the very portion of adultery, which a man he will indulge in. Who is the one who decide to you how much adultery you will do? Give me the name. Who is the one who decide how much adultery you will do?
No, but obviously Shaitan is not fixing adultery. He's making people do
this
it.
This is not the question. You see, don't play. You know, I don't have time for kids talk. I'm not a kid. I don't know how old are you. Be honest with me. Does it say Allah is the one who fixed the very portion of adultery, which means who is the one who decide how much adultery I do, you do, he do, she do? Does it say it is Allah who decide how much adultery we do for each one of us? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, but a second ago you said to me, Shaitan do that. So Allah is Shaitan. Because the one who made me do adultery is not Shaitan. It's Allah. When I asked you who is the one who make you do that, you said Shaitan without hesitation. Okay, now we find out that this is not from Shaitan. Shaitan is a good guy. He's a victim. Shaitan never do that. Allah is the real Shaitan in Islam. He is the one who made you do adultery. And he is the one who make you to do it as a must. You don't even have a choice to do or not. So you admitted that Shaitan is Allah and Allah is Shaitan.
Which hadith is that? Can you show me if it's Sahih?
Here we go. Sahih.
If it's plural or some?
Sahih Muslim 5657B. And I will post the link for you in the chat. So you can open it from your side and you can check it out. We don't make things up, my friend. Allah is Shaitan. There's no question. He is the one who make you do bad things. And then he blames Shaitan for the bad things you do. Which in fact, it's Allah. He decide for you to do those things. I advise you to leave Islam, my friend. You are worshipping Satan.
So how do we know? Because me personally, I've always had problems with the hadiths.
Well,
the Quran, Muslims do.
My friend, the Quran is not better. The Quran is very evil too. I mean, the Quran is very stupid, my friend. You see, the problem is that you.
Yes, but the hadiths were written 200-300 years later. So how
the
can
Quran
we even
is the
trust
same?
Them?
The Quran is the same, my friend. The Quran is the same. And by the way, we don't even have the books of the hadith. I mean, Islam is a joke. We don't have the original books of the Quran. We don't have even anything have to do with Uthman. We don't have anything. This is Sahih Muslim. We don't have the book of Sahih Muslim. You believe it? We don't have the book of Sahih Bukhari. I mean, this is a joke. Islam is a joke. You have nothing. You see, when the Christian, they say...
So which full book of the Bible do you have?
We have books where the one is written in leather and the one is written in the Egyptian papers. Those exist, but they are dissolved by time. But we have a shred of them. So we have thousands and thousands of shreds. All of them in total agreement with the Bible today. Right. My friend, listen. There is a reason. Those paper books, even if you don't touch them, if you put them in the drawer, after a long time, they will be demolished by themselves. First, because they are made by normal people who they are just making papers. It's paper made from
The question
the one who is existing,
we have
let me tell you why. First of all, we have many copies of the Bible in different languages. Many, as an example in Ethiopia, as an example the Egyptian, as an example even in India. Most the earliest Christians, they went all over the world. At the same time, we have art preserved, the story of the Bible, which go back to the time of Jesus, when Christians, they were going under the ground, and they were doing mosaic and art to preserve the crucifixion of Jesus, the verses in the Greek language or in Hebrew. Until now, we found them go back all the time to the time of Jesus. In the same time, when we question the Quran, I don't care really if it's preserved or not. The Quran is a stupid book. You see, I just told them before, I don't know if you were listening, I said, I don't want the Muslim to believe the Quran not preserved, because this is not for my benefit. If the Quran is preserved and it's a stupid book, That's for my benefit. That's it. The Quran is preserved. So you have no excuse to say, oh, somebody play with it. So when the Quran said the sun set in murky water, do you have an excuse? You say the hadith, I don't trust the hadith much. But what about the Quran? Before you call me, you heard me speaking about Gog and Magog. Who in the world would believe such a story? This is Quran. This is not hadith. And you keep saying to me, the Quran preserved. How in the world you in the year 2020, I don't know what is your education, believe that there is a man, his name is Dhul-Qurnayn. He got his first horn because he went to his people to make them to believe in Islam. They hit him in the hammer, in his head. He got the first horn and he died. Allah raised him back and he sent him back to his people. Then they hit him again with the hammer in his head, so he got two horns. And then the story continue. And then he keep, you know, Allah, he gave him a power. And then he occupied most of the earth. And he found where the sun set. And he found it sitting in murky water. The Muslim, they try to solve this problem. They say, oh, Dhul-Qurnayn, he thought, brother, don't you see the sun go in the water? My friend, it's even, it says a spring. Even the hadith, Muhammad, he said, confirming that the sun goes in water, which is hot and muddy. You know, here we go. This is the hadith, and this hadith is good. It's even sahih in chain. Narrated Abu Dhar, which means the father of the ants. He said, I was sitting behind Allah's messenger who was riding a donkey. While the sun was sitting, he asked, do you know where this set? I replied, Allah and his apostle know best. He said, it's set in a spring of warm water. Hamia. Do you see it? And this is in total agreement with the Quran. Total agreement with the Quran. So the Quran preserved. For me, I'm laughing. Okay, it's preserved. So what we will do now? This is against you, actually, not against me. Because you see, if I am a person who believe, if I'm speaking to someone who believe the Quran not preserved, he can say, oh, somebody put it there. There's no way this is from Allah. But because you believe now it's preserved word by word, then you cannot play games. You cannot say the hadith, I don't agree with it. This is Quran. And then the guy, he keep continue walking. And then he went, and look, it says, until he, when he reached the sitting place of the sun. The sitting place of the sun? Yeah, he reached it. And then he found it sitting in a spring of a bloody... You are laughing, huh?
You got me here, to be honest. It's a difficult book to defend.
Yeah,
but maybe I need more knowledge,
my
maybe
friend. The knowledge in the front of you. I'm helping you. I mean, you see, everything I'm saying to you, it's in the front of your screen. This is your Muslim translation. This is your Quran. You are my witness. It's not my website. I have nothing to do with it. How this can be from God? If I am you, I will leave. This is, you know, my friend. You are smarter than this. This is not even for good for kids. This is not good for cartoon. And then he go, and then what? He found it in the muddy water, and then he continue, and then he changed his direction, and he followed another way, in verse number 89. And then he, until when he came to the rising place of the sun. What is that? The sun rises everywhere. You don't need to go anywhere. Just stay home. I mean, this is a joke. And then he found it rising on people whom Allah had provided no shelter. This is supposed to be in Africa, you know, they are naked. And then, you know, we give him all the mean to whatever to do. And then he followed another way. And then, brother, he found people, like they are stupid. And they told him to build a dam between them and people of Gog and Magog. What do you think about Gog and Magog story? Do you like cartoon? Remember, the Quran is preserved. You are the one who said that to me. This is the preserved story of Allah.
Okay, so if it's not preserved, what do we do? What do I do?
No, it's not.
The Bible is not.
No, my friend. This is a joke to say that the Christian, they did not preserve the Bible. Why they want to do that? I mean, somebody believe from his heart in God. I will not say the Muslim would do that. I will not say the Hindu would. This is stupid, even claim. I mean, a guy is a Hindu. Why you want to change his book? This is stupid. I mean, this is not even This is the most stupid thing. A person who is a believer, he will not do that. And if a Christian, he agreed to do that. You see, you mentioned to me that the Christian, they have a conference to meet to discuss heretic, right? So here we go. They stand.
Yeah, even,
hold on, hold on, hold on.
Even here, the Jews don't agree with the
Christians. Here we go. So what? So what? No. The Jews agreeing. The 12 disciples of Jesus, they were Jews, my friend. They were not Hindus. They were not Arab. They were not the Christians. They were Jews. So you are wrong. So the first one who believed in Jesus was the Jews, no one else. We learn about Jesus from
so
the Jews.
Why don't Jews today believe in Jesus?
Who said the majority of them already Christians? What is left of the Jews is not even 20 million. After 2,000 years, there's only 20 million. What happened? Simply because the majority became Christians. What is left is the minority, not the majority. So
no, but there were more. Obviously, Hitler killed a lot of them. Other people killed a lot of them.
No problem. I mean, a lot of people died from the Jews, yes. But in the same time, the majority already are Christians. Same time, my friend. It's not logical to say to anyone. It's not logical for me even to say to a Muslim, you are playing with your book, because if he is a believer, he will not do that. No, nobody will do that. It doesn't matter what religion is. A person, he's a Hindu, he have a scriptures, he believe it's holy. Why you want to do that? This is a stupid argument. So don't go there. This is in front of us.
No, but maybe the Roman Empire needed a book.
My friend,
to
they
stand
cannot.
Behind.
They cannot, because not all the Christians under the Roman Empire. Christians are spread all over. Ethiopia is not under the Roman Empire, you know. And then the Roman Empire, they shrink, and the Roman Empire die. It doesn't exist no more. So why people want to do that? And nobody was able to hide one copy. I mean, this is a joke. All languages, you know, we believe, even in the books of Tafsir, it says that the disciple of Jesus, when Jesus told them to go and preach and teach, they said to him, well, how we will teach? We don't speak the last languages. So Allah, according to the Muslim interpretation, when they wake up in the morning, each one of them, he found himself speaking different language. So if the Greek book corrupt, okay, what about the Ethiopian book? What about the Coptic book? What about the Indian book? What about the Persian book?
Yeah, but you don't have many
my,
of
my
those.
Friend, my friend, my, my friend, you are running away from what is in front of you. This is the whole thing. You just admitted that this is stupid. Correct? You admitted this is stupid.
Or maybe we don't understand it the way it's meant to be.
No, my friend, it's in the front of you. You want to play a game? It's up to you. You know, it's about you, not about me, my friend. I don't care if you want to say whatever you want to say. But this is not. We don't understand. It's very simple. Gog and Magog, he built a dam between us and them. And then your prophet, he described that those, they tried to go out of the bridge, out of the dam. And then he woke up in the morning. He said, today there is people who... the people of Gog and Magog, they were able to like this in the wall. We to Allah, to the Arab for today, a little tiny hole open. So this is it's explained already. It's explained. It's not a choice to say, oh, maybe we don't understand it, because Muhammad, he mentioned it even in the hadith, and those hadith are accurate, sahih. So what we will do with it? Read it. Abu Huraira said, Allah Apostle, he said, today the wall barrier between Gog and Magog has been opened so much. And he was terrified, and he was telling the Arab, oh, are we to the Arab, you know, what's coming to you? All those hadith are sahih. See, sahih al-Bukhari. He woke up in the morning, his face is red, he's terrified. He was saying, La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah. And then they said to him, what's happening? He said, the great evil happened. Today, a gap has been opened, and he made a space between his hand about how big it is of people of Gog and Magog. And those are 1,000 to 1, which means if we are 7 billions, the Gog and Magog, they are 7 trillions. So where are they? Where is this dam? And who in the world would believe in such a story? He built a dam. They can go around the dam. I mean, the earth.
But that's like asking where is the Garden of Eden?
No, because those are people in earth. They are in the earth. Those are not in the
so
sky.
So where is the Garden of Eden according to the Bible? It was on earth. It wasn't in space.
What?
Where was the Garden of Eden? It was on earth. according to the Bible.
Yes, but
he wasn't floating in space.
Yes, and we know the location in the north of Iraq. So, but in the Garden of Eden in Islam, it is in heaven. What does this have to do with this, my friend? It's a garden. It's not when we say heaven when it comes to Adam and Eve. It's a garden. It's just a place. God providing with everything. It's not really heaven as you imagine now, like the 70 version, etc. But here, notice with me that Muhammad, he explained to you, he have tons of stories about Gog and Magog, and all of them, they are authentic hadith in total agreement with the Quran. How you today, and you said, you just agreed that this is stupid, this is not right, you got me here, this is what you said. How you want to stay as a Muslim with this? What is this? All of those stories, look how many.
Maybe I need to ask my scholars about more information.
Well, your scholars, they cannot say to you anything except what I'm showing you on the screen. This is your scholar talking. Or do you think I'm giving you, is your scholar is better than Al-Bukhari? You know? What are your scholars? If there is a scholar in Islam, they will be calling me, my friend. They don't dare. Did you ask yourself, what is the scholars? Why they don't call me? We just have an Arab, I don't know if you heard him, he ran away. He ran away, literally, I just asked him, he said to me, this hadith is fabricated. I said, prove it, go ahead. He ran away.
So what about the prophecy of Muhammad in the Bible? He's prophesied Jesus.
My friend. I mean, you Muslims are really crazy. A second ago, you are saying to me, it's corrupted, the book is corrupted. And now you find him in the Bible. So if the Bible is corrupt, that means the prophecy is corrupted. Secondly, all those are, you call them prophecy, are not true. Actually, the opposite. It says, like, you know, I mean, it is really stupid. Did you even read what the Muslim, they say to you? Go and check the verses yourself. Read a few verses before, a few verses after, you will die laughing. One of the videos on YouTube, it's very popular. They say it's in Muhammad is an Isaiah. When the verse is speaking about God, they made Muhammad God. The verse says the Lord. The guy, he cut it and he started reading after. Why? Because in a second people will notice that this is speaking about God. They lie to you. You know, you mentioned to me that Muhammad is a prophet, right? And Muhammad, he received his knowledge from who? From Allah, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Do you, what is your education? Like, did you finish a school, university, anything?
University.
All right, that's wonderful. So I'm talking to an educated person. That's wonderful. How the baby is created? Have you ever heard of someone who claimed to be God, and then he say this, that the sperm became a congealed dead blood? Which God is that? He says such a thing. And then the Muslim, they make videos saying this is scientific, and they start fabricating the translation and the meaning. Then we made the sperm into a clot of a congealed blood. Congealed blood, the sperm will became a congealed blood. This is God. And then the clot, we made it into a lump. And then we made out of the lump a bones and clothes. And the bones, which mean at the end we have bones, just bones, there's nothing. And then we close the bones. So the start is stupid, the end is even more funny. And look at the translation. You said you do not know Arabic, right?
Yeah, but that's not meant to be a scientific book.
No, it's meant.
Just because
No. You see, when you speak in such details, that is not metaphorical no more. He's telling you stages by stage by stage. This is not just metaphorical. I can say, I agree. You know, we can say that, like in the Bible, it says you made me in such a way. My friend.
Terms we use today.
My friend.
One back then would understand it, isn't it?
Yeah, at that time, people, they take it because they didn't know what he's talking about. Simply, this is not stupid.
If he says, we're going to create this embryo, and we're going to make this and this and this, one's going to understand.
But still, he don't have to be stupid, right? I mean, he can say how he created, and then we will be amazed now when we discover it. But he don't be stupid. He don't say we made the sperm and took a congealed blood. Or what about chapter 86, where it says that women have a sperm and coming from her ribs? And the man have a sperm is coming from his backbone. I mean, what kind of God he say that? Women don't have a sperm. And the sperm of the man is not coming from the backbone. You can go right now and check in Nicathir. He will say to you that this is meaning the sperm of the man coming from the backbone and the sperm of the women, the water of the women, which is yellow, as Muhammad described it, coming in from the location of the necklace. This is what the water rib mean. It's a word used for women, ribs, specific location of the ribs, the top one. So how this can be God? So look, the sun set in murky water. He found where the sun set. He found where the sun rise. He found where next to it. He built Gog and Magog. A story of the cave people, which is funny and stupid. You know, it's a fiction story written by a Christian priest in Syria for the Christian youth. It's fiction. All the Christians knew that. So they, you know, he took it. He put it in the Quran. When a Jewish man, he came to Muhammad and he said to him, what is the signs of the hour? Do you know the story?
No, not this one.
He asked him, he said to him, I want to ask you a question which nobody know the answer for it except a prophet of God. This is the hadith, this is Sahih Bukhari. So nobody can say it's weak. So he said to him, there's certain things I'm going to ask him about things. He said, I'm going to ask him about three things which only a prophet can know the answer or can answer it. Wonderful. I mean, look how the story is stupid from the beginning. The guy, he knew the answer, and he is saying only prophet knew the answer. Have you ever heard of a stupid? This is your prophet saying that. This is a story coming from your prophet. I come to you and I say to you, I'm going to ask you a question. Only prophet knew the correct answer, but I know the correct answer, so I must be prophet too. So it's a stupid cult, man. It is just a madness, a stupidity. It's a low IQ. And then he continued. He said to him, and look at the questions. I mean, look at this very hard exam. What is the first food which people of paradise will eat? Like what? This is the question which nobody knows except prophet. Why does the child attract the similarity of his father or to his mother? Then the prophet replied, said, Jibreel, just inform me now. Look, what? So Muhammad now, he cannot claim that he is getting something stupid. Jibreel from Allah, inform me that, etc. He said, and then Ibn Salam, he said to him, Jibreel, the enemy of the Jews. Since when Jibreel, the enemy of the Jews? Anyway, so then he says, as the first sign of the hour, it will be the fire will collect people from the east to the west. Okay, where it says in the Quran, this fire will collect them from the east and the west. As for the first meal, the people of paradise will eat will be the loop of the fish liver. Why? Because people will go to have sex. The Arab, they believe that the whale, not the fish, the whale liver is very good for sex. You know, they take from it al-ambar. You can check it out. As the ambar is even, you know, the deer, he have the same hormone, which is used to attract female. So Muhammad, the Arab, they learn that those things, they attract females. So they think they can attract female, but this was for the deer. Anyway, as for the child, if a man discharge proceed, then the women discharge, the child attract the similarity to the man. Look at this stupid. He just said, if you have orgasm first, the baby will be a boy. If you have orgasm, the women have orgasm first, the baby will be a girl. What does this have to do with this? According to which science? And remember, he said, Jibreel told me. So we cannot say Muhammad is making, I mean, somebody fool him. He was just, as you said, he is just a human. He just said, Jibreel told me. So either Jibreel told him or he's a liar.
Maybe he lied.
You are right. Obviously, he's lied. He lied because this is absolutely false. So you just left Islam, my friend. You just left Islam right now. I'm happy for you. You decide to use your brain, and you are out. The second you use your brain, you are out of Islam, and now you are out of Islam. I'm really happy for you. I'm so glad you called me today so we can share the truth with you. It's obvious this man is speaking.
So what do I do with this? Okay, let's say Islam is false. What do I do with this?
Well, you know, now you have to think. I mean, okay, Islam is false. I can invite you to believe in Jesus if you want. But first you have to clear yourself from all the dirt of and the garbage of Muhammad. With my respect to you, you see, if we have a computer, have a virus, we cannot install a new clean software without formatting the virus. You have to clean yourself from the garbage of Muhammad. You have to believe in the Holy God. The Holy God is what Jesus, he brought to us. The Holy God is what Jesus taught us. If a man, he look at a woman and he wished to have her, he committed adultery. Not, you know, God, he made you do adultery.
Okay, so if people lie to me all my life about this, they never show me this, how can I trust anyone else? Even
Did I say to you, trust me? Did I say to you? No. You are a man, you are adult, you went to school, you have a degree, you speak languages, you have a computer, do your research, study very well, and search holiness. The one, you know, once a big sheikh came to my father, and he said to him, you know, you are a great man, a great family, you are very well known. Why you don't I invite you to accept Islam? You know, the sheikh saying that to my dad. So my dad, he said to him nicely, he didn't want to be polite with him because he's in our house and he is a friend of him. He said to him, well, yeah, sheikh, where is Muhammad now? He said, he's dead. He said to him, where is Jesus now? He said, he's in heaven. He said, well, I will follow the one in heaven. So ask yourself a very simple question. Which one you want to follow? The one who, as you mentioned, and you said, he is perfect. The one who is right now in heaven. The one who never commits sin. The one who taught holiness and he was holy. You see, I can say to you, be good, don't do that and do that. But I have to admit, I do sin. You know, I'm not even close to claim to be anything good about me. You know, only God is good. So when we speak about Jesus, a different story. Jesus, he challenged the Jews. Who can of you prove me to be a sinner? Who can? Who dare? I cannot say that to you, because if I say that to you, I will be a hypocrite. I am a sinner. So when we speak about the Messiah, we speak about holiness. Jesus, he said to us, if you want to go to my heaven, let's go how to pray. He said, pray like this. And then he said, forgive to us the same we forgive to others. And then you will notice that Jesus in the cross, he said, forgive them, Father, they do not know what they are doing. So imagine if Jesus, he said, forgive them, and yet he don't want to forgive. Even in the cross, when people are calling him names, killing him literally, I mean, crucifying, how ugly, how evil, how much pain, yet he is saying, Father, forgive them, they don't know what they are doing. So when Jesus says to us, forgive, he was truthful. He did it, even when he is dying in the cross. And death for him means nothing.
I have no problem with Jesus being the best, the most righteous, not a single sin and everything. And that he was peaceful, he never raised a hand or did anything wrong. But how can he claim to be God, though? That's the biggest problem. How can he claim? What? Even if you're the most perfect prophet of God, you're still giving the message of God, isn't it? You don't claim for yourself God. You do miracles and do everything.
Okay, you see, you know, I when we ask a Muslim, why Allah chose Muhammad? They say, Allah, we don't ask him why he chose, right? Now, why Jesus, he claimed to be God? Well, if he is claiming to be God, then he should not be able to do what God can do. I can claim to be God too. You can claim to be God. Talk is cheap. I can go right down the street and I say, hey, I'm God. Okay, people, they will ask me, do you know the guy from India, he claimed to be the Messiah? Ahmad Mirza Ghulam? The Ahmadiyya guy? Hello? You remember him?
Hello?
Yeah, you remember Ahmad Mirza Ghulam? Do you remember Ahmad Mirza Ghulam? Yeah, this guy, anyway, you can search him. He claimed to be the Messiah. He claimed to be the Messiah. Okay. And then second day, people, they come to his house and they have people in a wheelchair, people, they are blind, people, they cannot see, people, they are sick. And they say to him, okay, you are the Messiah, do what the Messiah does. He made the blind see. He healed the leper. He made the one who cannot walk,
yes,
walk. Okay. So when Jesus, he make a claim, it is a claim until he prove it is true. And he did. He did what nobody can do. Resurrecting people from death, making the blind see. I mean, he ordered the nature. One word of him, it's a must. So there's difference between somebody claim, Muhammad claimed to be a prophet, and here we go, you agreed he's a liar. I can claim to be a prophet, you can claim. It's a good business, by the way. These days, I mean, this is the best business ever in history, always. Anyone want to make money, he can make himself a prophet. He will find some fool, and they will give him his money, and that's it. He will live like a king, and then he will start sleeping with the women. Jesus never asked for money. Jesus never have a woman. Jesus never even own a donkey. Jesus never own a house. Jesus never have a palace. I mean, imagine you are in a now and before, nothing changed. If I can raise people from death, how many kings they will worship me and they will be under my command? I will be their boss forever because they will die. They knew it's coming. They have a person who will make them alive again. So he did not abuse the power. He was not seeking power, for he is the true God in this earth. So when we question how this has happened, well, God, because the Bible says, for God, he loved the world. This is why he came to us. Not because he need to, but because he loved to. There's a huge difference. God did not create me because he need me. He don't need me. He want to share his glory with us. He wanted us to be happy. This is why in Christianity we have different form of speaking to God. We call him Father. We don't say, yes, he is God, but imagine our relationship is not about God. It's about children and their father. This is how much loving he is. And the Quran says, I created not a human or genie except to worship me. The Bible teaches different, totally the opposite direction. This is why you speak to the Father and you pray to the Father, because he is your Father. He is your God, yes, but he is not an evil one. He loves you. So when I speak about Jesus, I try to find the intention of this person. His name is Jesus. What he want from me? What he want? Did he want something from me? No. Did he ask for something? No. Did he ask for the fifth of the booty like Muhammad? No. Did he ask women, hey, give yourself to me? No. He asked you to be holy. He asked you to be loving. He said, love your enemy. I mean, everything he said is for the benefit of mankind. Nobody can question that. Love your enemy. I mean, imagine, my friend, if all mankind, they practice one sentence of Jesus, which is love your enemy. Guess what? We will have no war. We will have no thieves. We will have no criminals. We will have no death. We will have no people crying, because people love each other. Just one sentence of Christ's teaching is the solution for mankind. Not the book. You see, just sentence is better than all the books in the world, all the book of wisdom. So Jesus did not fail. Jesus did not fail, my friend. We fail. We fail to love each other. We fail to be good to each other. In the Quran, go attack them, go kill them, go take their money, go, etc. And then somebody will say to you, oh, and you know, like in the Old Testament, there's war. You know, we have to understand that those people, they are under attack too. The Jewish, they were trying to survive. But Jesus, he wants us to take us to higher level. Everything was to prepare for the coming of Jesus, to the point where he can say, love your enemy. And still after 2,000 years, people don't want to listen. People full of hate. Christians are not being Christians. Jewish are not being Jewish. Muslims killing each other. You know, war everywhere, corona, crazy stuff. Even people want to use, they want to use people just even when they are dying from corona. People, they want to hack corona, want to sell it in the market. I mean, even death is a business in the world today. So with the Messiah, we have a new life. And I invite you, my friend, you are a smart person. I invite you to the best I have. His name is the Messiah. I invite you to accept him as your Lord, as your Savior. And it's up to you.
I will.
You will. Do you accept the Messiah as your Savior?
Yes.
I mean to that. Hallelujah. a happiness today in the kingdom of God. We have our friends. Did you hear it, people? Praise the Lord. We have a child of God. He came back home. Don't think that Jesus is the winner. You are the winner. Don't think Christian Prince, he won a debate. I did not. You are the winner. I lost from my time, my friend, and you are the winner. I spend my night with you, but you are the winner. It's not me. And it's not the Messiah. It's you. I'm so happy for you. I say and I pray that the Lord will bless you, bless your family. And if you need me to talk to them, I will be so happy to talk to them, and I will speak to them. I will promise you, I will speak to them very politely, your parents, anyone you want. I will be happy. You can contact me anytime, and I will be happy to talk to them. And today you are a new person. Today you need to forget about all bad things you learned from Muhammad, all bad things you learned from this madness. You are a child of God, my friend. You are a loving person. You are a new person. Do you have a copy of the Bible?
Yes.
All right. Well, I advise you to start reading from the book of John. And I want you to read, you know, let me tell you about how I read. And maybe I'm not telling you how to read, by the way. I'm saying to you how let us take it from a brother of you, you know, like how I do things, let us say. All right. I'm not going to teach you how to read. But when you read the Bible, don't read it as a story. Live the story. So you can imagine it. Imagine that Jesus is speaking. Imagine people they are around. Imagine people they are asking. Imagine Jesus is answering. And then you can live the story. And then you can observe it better. And you will find how amazing Christ's teaching is. Read, ask, learn. And the more you read, the more you will notice that you are learning more. Which means the same chapter, if I go right now to John chapter 1, after all those years, how many times I did read it? If I start reading now and I sit alone, I will find something new. The Lord will inspire me. The Lord will open my eyes. So I pray the Lord will open your eyes and he will inspire you and he will teach you, not me. No man can teach, only God. And this is why we are listening to the word of the Lord, and he is the only teacher. He's the only master we have. It's not Peter who teach us. It's not Paul who teach us, as Muslims they say to you. We are following Jesus. We don't follow any man. The rest are just disciples, and you can be one of them. You can be a disciple of the Lord and bring as many Muslims as you can. And the Lord will be so happy to have you.
I will show them what you showed me.
Contact me if they want to talk to me. If they don't want to go live, no problem. We can go in private. But if they want to go live, even better. And I promise you, I will speak to your family in a very respectful way. Even though it's
My family is Christian.
Your family is a Christian. So what happened?
I guess I lost my way.
Well, you are back, my friend. I'm so happy for you. Your family are saved, and today you are saved. Go tell your mom. Go. Tell your mom, hey, I became a Christian. I'm back. I'm back home. Let her cry and give you a hug. I'm sure she...
Thank you for showing me all this.
I'm so happy for you, my friend. Do you want to say anything to people around you? People are happy for you. Look how people are happy for you.
Yeah, I'm watching the chat. Thank you all, and God bless you.
All right, my friend. God bless you, and God bless your mother and your father and your family, and we pray for them, all of them. And I'm happy that today your new year is different. The family new year is different. Now you have a Christmas next year. Next year you will be the first to say to your mother, Merry Christmas, Mom. Praise the Lord.
Thank you. Praise the Lord.
Thank you for calling. Take care.
Good night. Bye-bye. Good night, brother. Good night.
My throat is hurting me. I told you I don't feel good when I go live, but it's worth it. It's worth it. And I'm sure his mother, she will be very happy to hear that he is back to Christ and he is saved. and he's out of the devil house. Pray for him that the Lord will keep him strong and will protect him and protect his family. And we pray that the Lord, he will bring more people using him to Christ. I apologize, guys. I cannot really stay long. My throat is really hurting badly. I wasn't going to go live today. I told you from the beginning, I'm not going to stay long. I hardly can talk. Each time I open my mouth, it's really hurting. I think I have a bad throat infection, maybe. I want to say, you do your best. You don't know what you would accomplish. You know, this brother, he called us. He was angry from me. He was upset from me. He was etc. But you never know. You never know. This is why the Lord, he chose fishermen. You know, he told us to be fisher, to go and fish. And our fishing is different. It's to save, not to kill. It's to secure, not to harm. So I'm glad that he called us today, and I pray that every day we will have more Muslims to call. They call us as Muslims, they hang up as a Christians. And this is not the first time happen. We have thousands of Muslims who left Islam watching our videos. Some they left on air, sometime in private because they don't want to speak about it. Sometime even I don't know about them and they say to me in the chat. So we are happy for everybody. And until we see you, if I am okay tomorrow, I will go live. Subscribe, join us. You can follow us in Patreon too if you care. And until we see you soon again, I say may the Lord bless you, protect you, and keep you safe. And this is your brother Christian Prince. Wish you the best. And don't forget again to pray for our friend. We do not know his name. Pray for him. Doesn't matter who is he. We pray that he will be a light in his house and for people around. Thank you, and God bless you. Take care. Yeah.